Recently, I've come to the realization that I genuinely enjoy suffering, and to be honest, I think that you do too, without even realizing it. I guess this way of thinking started to come out recently when I started to watch a lot of videos on YouTube about Berserk and start to reread some of the chapters. No manga or anime has quite impacted me like Berserk, and it still does to this day. For those who aren't familiar with it, Berserk is a very dark horror fantasy story, and the main character Guts is the embodiment of suffering. This man's whole life, starting from when he was born out of his mother's dead womb, has been a struggle. I know based on the start of this and how doom and gloom the title is of this video that you might think this is gonna be a depressing video, but I promise you it's not. Just listen to what I have to say about this. This character Guts is someone that I idolize. I idolize a man whose life has been nothing but pain. Why would I idolize a man like this? It's almost like I wish that I were him sometimes. I catch myself having that thought. I wish I was someone whose life has been harder than anyone I've ever read about. And that got me thinking, do I wish I had more suffering in my life? Does everyone secretly wish that they had more pain and suffering in their life, or at least most people who live comfortable lives? When I really thought about it, I realized that a part of me truly does enjoy the negative side of life, the pain, the suffering. I know it sounds like I'm trying to be that, oh, that's so deep, bro, 14-year-old dude on the internet, but really when I think about it, all of the meaning that I've derived from my life has been through some sort of struggle or some side of the negative aspect of life. Or at least almost all of it. I'm gonna get to the positive side of life as well and how that's impacted me. For a very long period of time, I tried to fight this off, and I can specifically remember a time halfway through my junior year where I was trying to do this. This is when I was still with my second girlfriend, and that's gonna play a part later in this story, but every day as I was driving to my classes midway through junior year, I would listen to Alan Watts' teachings, his lectures on YouTube about Eastern religion and philosophy. And through that, I learned the techniques to free myself from any and all desires. I eradicated all meaning in my life to try and free myself from the shackles of suffering, and all of that did was made me go kind of crazy. When you read about these teachings and this philosophy and religion and you interpret it in the wrong way, this can absolutely happen to you. I kind of lost my mind. I stopped uploading on YouTube for a while. I broke up with my second girlfriend during that time, but we shortly got back together a few months after, and I wasn't really feeling much of anything. I had, like, not a lot of feeling. And after reflecting on that period of time in my life now, I realized that that sort of thinking is just not for me. I still practice a lot of the philosophies and ideas from Eastern philosophy, but I don't want to free myself from all desires. And technically, this is the end result that you're trying to get at when you are studying Buddhism, because desiring not to desire is a desire in itself. So I realized that I don't want to free myself from all desires, even if that means that I have to suffer a lot. Honestly, I think that my pursuit in life to remove the meaning from it was secretly an act of self-sabotage, an act of wanting to suffer. The more I think about it, the more I think that we all do this to some extent in order to feel more human. This is because pain and pleasure are two sides of the same coin. Without pleasure, pain would not exist, and without pain, pleasure would not exist. And in fact, painful situations can produce the same sensations as pleasure, and vice versa. And the one example of this that will really make people listen to what I'm saying right now is sex. When you think about making love with someone, the faces that you make, the sounds that you make, are very, very similar to the faces and sound you make when you're in immense pain. Again, pleasure is the same thing as pain, on just a different side of a coin. And both of these make you feel much more human than if you're just totally complacent. I feel I've become somewhat addicted to feeling uncomfortable or having some sort of suffering, at least a little bit. You know, when I think about working out, you're putting yourself through a painful situation, trying to grind out that last rep. It hurts your body, and I like that feeling. Same can be said for when I'm sad and I want to listen to sad music to make me more sad. That feeling feels good. And I embrace having a ton of work to do and having a little amount of time to do it. I like having that sort of pressure. I even embrace people not treating me right, because every single one of those experiences leaves some room for growth and leaves room of me knowing that something incredible people is going to happen in the future. By listening to this, you might think that I'm a masochist, but I enjoy the opposite end of the spectrum, pleasure, as much as I do pain and suffering, and honestly, all of us deep down are a little masochistic. You just don't want to admit it. Life is always going to come in ebbs and flows, and there would be no such thing as positive experiences if negative experiences didn't exist. Repeat that in your head. You wouldn't even know what positivity is or looks or feels like if negativity didn't exist. And that means that negativity is necessary for us to feel happiness. There was a point in time over the summer around June, July, and August where I was the happiest, the most pleasureful, the most joyful that I've ever been, I feel like, in my entire life. And I tried to think about what was it during that time period that really made me feel that way? What could I possibly have been doing during that time to make me feel so pleasureful? And I realized that the time before that, the few months before that period, were the lowest point in my life, were the most negative point in my life, where I had the most pain. So in fact, all that pain and suffering that I went through, that I thought I wish never I went through, actually brought me to the most pleasureful moment in my life. And during this period of time in my life, right now, I felt that something was off, like I've said in a couple of my previous videos. Being in this house, in this gated community, with one other roommate, and having everything I need and more, why do I feel so off? It really makes me want to struggle in some way, and that made me realize one thing. Complacency is far worse than any sort of low or any sort of high that you can experience. If I'm in a very painful and uncomfortable situation, I at least know that what comes after it is something super positive, and at least I feel like human and I feel alive during that time of pain and suffering. But if you're just comfortable, if you're in the middle of suffering and being in a super pleasureful state, then you just feel nothing. You don't really feel human. This is what happens when you're comfortable and striving for nothing and not pushing your limits or trying to feel some sort of pain. Nothing feels worse to me than not feeling happy nor sad, than being in this flat line. Now, of course, the highs are just as beneficial as the lows. The positivity aspect of this is just as beneficial because it can also push you to grow and push you to be a better person because you are in such a great state. But I'm not going over the positive spectrum of this because, let's be honest, we don't struggle with the positivity. People really struggle with accepting and embracing the evil within them, which I believe, honestly, every human has to some extent. Now, here's the problem that most people have. They weigh themselves too much to one side. You need a healthy balance of the highs and lows in life in order to live the optimal life, I believe. You can't just pursue and become addicted to pain and suffering and vice versa with positivity and pleasureful situations. I don't think the universe would have evil within it were it not completely necessary for you. The universe was constructed in a way to have both positive and negative. And so you say, I wish things were simpler and easier in life, but do you really? Is that really what you want? Because I would argue it's not. It's only because you fail to look at pain and suffering and how the universe is really constructed in order for us to thrive. Now, I'm not encouraging you to be a piece of shit and cause harm to yourself and others and be negative all the time. Please don't hurt other people and hurt yourself. What I am saying is that when pain or suffering arises in one of its forms, you now have the awareness that this can be something that is actually enjoyable. So maybe the real reason that I idolize Guts as a character is because he came to this realization far more early in his life than I did, and that mindset was what I was secretly looking for all along.